stuck between the 5600X, 7600X, and now the 9600X, let me explain what actually matters. This video is about AMD's newest 6-core and 12-thread processor, the 9600X. For the important bits, it's built on the new 4-nanometer technology on Zen 5 architecture. It's efficient and forward-looking, meaning that you're not going to be restricted to upgrades, and it hits the sweet spot for value builds right now. It's AM5 and also DDR5, PCIe5, meaning that you've got many upgrade channels in the future. AMD has promised AM5 support through to 2027, so you know by buying this, you're not buying into a dead end. Now, this video does focus on the 9600X, but to see its value, we need to look at the 5600X and 7600X as its direct predecessors. For this table, we're going to move from the 5600 to the 7600 to the 9600X in order. Starting with architecture, we've gone from Zen 3 to Zen 4 to Zen 5. All this means is that it's newer technology and therefore better. The processing nodes have gone from 7 to 5 to 4 nanometers, meaning that it's faster and more efficient. Sockets is AM4 for the 5600X, AM5 for the 7600X, and for the 9600X. All three are 6-core and 12-thread processors. Looking at the clocks, the 5600X has a base of 3.7 and boosts up to 4.6. The 7600 has a base clock of 4.7 and moves up to 5.3. And the 9600X has a base clock of 3.9 gigahertz and moves up to 5.4. Next, let's move on to the caches because this makes a difference when it comes to gaming and performance. The L1 cache for the 56 and 5700X is 384 kilobytes, but for the 9600X, it's 480 kilobytes. The L2 cache is 3 megabytes for the 5600X, but it goes up to 6 megabytes for the 76 and 9600X. And lastly, all three have a 32 megabyte L3 cache. Looking at the TDPs, 65 watts for the 5600X, 105 watts for the 7600X, and back down to 65 watts for the 9600X, just claiming on efficiency, meaning that it's a highly energy efficient CPU. Onto PCIe support, the 5600X is PCIe 4, the 7600 is PCIe 5, and the 9600X is also PCIe 5. Moving on to memory support, the 5600X supports DDR4 only, and the 76 and 9600X only support DDR5. On motherboard options, the 5600X can only operate on AM4 motherboards, which are older technology, and then the 76 and 9600X can operate on AM5 technology, which, as mentioned before, will be supported up to 2027 at least.
The TLDR is, I don't recommend the 5600X as you're going to be buying into a dead end. But the real question is, should you get the 7600X or the 9600X? And there are many opinions, so here's mine. The 9600X is more expensive than the 7600X by about $40 in the US or up to 800 Rand in South Africa, depending on where you shop. But sometimes there is no difference. Currently on Amazon, there is no difference. But on average, it's around 15% more expensive to get the 9600X. But the general performance of the 9600X is only 3 to 10% better than the 7600. So logic dictates that the 7600 is a better buy. However, there's a critical difference in the 9600X being more energy efficient, which means less electricity bills and lower temperatures on the CPU. So it's a hard call, but my gut says the 9600X, as I believe it's a more rounded CPU for all purposes.
So gaming, streaming, and editing, the 9600X is going to be able to handle all and handle all well. And in most cases, your GPU will hit its limit before the CPU does. So basically, the 5600X is more of a dead pathway. The 7600X is still a good CPU, but the 9600X offers very good value for money and performance according to the current specs. But no, the 9600X is not the most powerful CPU that AMD makes. But for people that are building now that want performance without overkill, this might just be the smartest CPU move. It's modern, efficient, and leaves headroom for upgrades without blowing your entire budget. Sometimes simple is smart. Hope you enjoyed this video. Cheers, goodbye.